So we did the integral of ln x, not there, integration by parts. Here we go. So what do we do here? We took u to be the ln part, and then dv was basically just dx. So naively, we can just try this again. Maybe we'll take that whole ln of all that stuff to be u, and then dv is just 1 dx. So that's a reasonable way to start this problem here. So let's go ahead and try it that way. So u is going to be ln of all this stuff. And dv is just 1 dx. So regular v is x. And du, derivative of this, is 1 over x squared plus 15x plus 44. And out of the chain rule, we get 2x plus 15. And I'll write in the numerator. So are there any questions on the substitutions we're about to make? You can generally, as long as you can find your antiderivative, you can generally apply integration by parts. It may not get you where you want to go. So it may be a worse integral. So we're going to hope for the best here. So we got uv, which is x, ln of all that stuff, minus integral of v, which is x, du is all that stuff there, so the real question is, can we now integrate this guy? So you're always creating a new integral whenever you do integration by parts. It's just whether or not you can integrate that new integral. So I could distribute the x into the top, although I'm not sure that that's necessarily the best move here. I'll go ahead and do it. Yep, absolutely. So I don't know if this is going to work out coincidentally nicely on this problem. So whenever you have a rational function, we're going to deal with those using partial fractions, but that's two sections ahead. However, oh no, this won't work because there's a 2x squared on the top and only a regular x squared. All right, so I think we're going to have to stop here. All right, do you remember polynomial division?
Yep. Yeah.
So that's exactly what's written right here. Take this polynomial divided by this other polynomial. Unfortunately, there's a very, very small chance. Certainly this degree 2 polynomial is not a factor of the other one. So it is not going to, they're going to get a remainder. However, the remainder is going to be 1 degree lower than the original. All right, here is a good example of why synthetic division is not going to work in general, because we have a degree 2 polynomial. You'd have to do it in two separate divisions if you did synthetic division. All right, what do I multiply by?
2.
2. Doesn't matter where you write the 2. Whoa, 2? No. What do I multiply by?
-2.
No. 1/2. There we go. So I need to turn
2x squared into regular x squared. So I got to knock out the 2. This is a slightly different division than you're used to. Same rules apply, but the degrees are the same. So we're not multiplying by any x's here.
So we got x squared plus 15 halves x. And we're subtracting, so 15 minus 15 halves is just 15 halves.
All right, you do not keep going.
Wait, why not?
Is that right? 15 minus 15 halves is 15 halves? Seems right. Or you can go 30 halves and minus 15 halves if you're into common denominators. All right, how do we write this out? The result of this division is, if I write x squared plus 15x plus 44,
I just divided them the wrong order, because division is not commutative. I totally divided them in the wrong order.
Well, you should have said that out loud.
So there is a missing term in this polynomial, so we're going to fill that in. We got plus 0, so there's no constant term. All right, now what do I multiply x squared by?
2. There we go.
We were right all along.